This video was made possible by EA Game Changers. What is up, me little sugar buggers? Welcome back to the channel for a brand new speed build. So today, you guys, we are renovating the entire floor of Drake Hall, which just happens to be a dorm location located in Brightchester University. So I don't know about you guys, but looking at the before, I really don't feel like this is Drake Hall or the prestigious Brightchester that it claims. So I wanted to go ahead and get the entire floor plan and kind of replace it with my own vision, because this particular location is very, very, very vital for our LP. In fact, this is the place that we are going to be residing. And you're probably wondering, Jen, where the hell is that LP? If I had to sit here and list off every single thing that I have done for you guys to like make the form ends up to date and for it all to kind of make sense, you would probably be flabbergasted. And I'm not even done. So I don't know what I'm going to do with what I thought I was going to do in the first place, which I know I'm confusing you. But we're going to have to cut some damn corners, but at least the gameplay part will absolutely 122% be there. Anyway, so the before of Drake Hall, it was very like bright, it was very bland, it was very weird. Like, there was just random pieces of furniture. Like, that to me doesn't signify prestigious. That to me does not, you know, equate how much I'm paying for my dorm rent or my tuition to even go here. I feel like Drake Hall, or even the other hall that's actually located on campus, just Brightchester in general, it should reflect how upscale, how, you know, pretentious it is claiming it to be. It should feel very exclusive and selective, and it should be an honor to even be staying at the dorms. And so I really wanted it to reflect that luxurious entity that it possesses, and I'm so freaking excited for how this build turned out. So the first thing that I'm working on is the bathroom. I love, 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 love how this bathroom looks. Now, the only thing that throws me the hell off is the showers. I want to know why my nalgas are sitting out in the open for little Timmy to sit there and gawk at while he's washing his hands with some dial soap. Like, I need to know. They're a little weird. I mean, at home, it's one thing, but since this is kind of like a unisex bathroom, I feel like there should just be a little more privacy, because if not, just take the damn freaking doors off the hinges of the bathroom stall. Like, it just didn't make a lot of sense to me. And no, I didn't fix it because I didn't think about it until now. Anyway, we've got, I think, 5 dorm rooms in this particular lot. We've got a library, which I'm working on now. We've got a little area where you can kind of chill out. There's like a nice fireplace, a big fat flat screen TV. And my favorite part of the build has got to be this library. When I saw that there was one in Drake Hall, I was super, super duper inspired. Like, I wanted to renovate this small little space so freaking bad. And so I put a bunch of like these bookshelves in. I think I used the ones base game, apparently. I used the really kind of like pancake style bookshelves that are base game. I tried to limit my amount of packs that I used, but unfortunately, this is kind of like a cluster duck of different types of packs and things that I used in this particular build. But I'm pretty positive it won't be that hard for you guys to like switch it out and put whatever you want in here. I just, like I said, I'm making it for my LP, and I wanted to be able to like really immerse myself in the build, and I wanted to have that, you know, creative freedom of using whatever pack that I wanted. So I tried my best to incorporate many objects from Discovery University, because at the end of the day, that's what it is. It's a Discovery University build. But I was so pleasantly surprised that every freaking pack I had, every pack that I owned, just kind of blended in so seamlessly. It was crazy. I could literally pick and pull from all different packs, and it would just work with this particular build. Like, I can't exactly remember where these rugs came from. I want to say Get Famous. And look at how beautiful, look at how amazingly they fit into the build. Like, it was meant to freaking be. It's kind of crazy. It makes me feel like they knew that Discovery University was coming all along, and, you know, like, it's just kind of been building up to this moment. I don't know. Maybe I'm crazy, but anyways, here's like the little hangout area. This is like the common section of Drake Hall. I put in like, you know, plenty of seating. I think I even have like an easel in here for your more creative Sims. I do try to keep things relatively kind of open and airy. I didn't want to clutter it up too much for multiple reasons. The biggest reason being like obviously gameplay performance. I know a lot of you guys probably do have beefy computers, but there's some that don't. And I feel like at this point, like, I did a nice little balance to where if you wanted to come in and add more things, you totally could. But I also would feel like a lot of this stuff would be a liability because it looks expensive. And you know what? I'm pretty sure Brightchester University doesn't want you to have, you know, one beer pong too many and go knock over the Tiffany lamp or, you know, make some mockings in their chestnut wood fireplace. It's probably not something that they're down for, but I really, like I said, I'm so excited to play in this build. I love it. I love it. I love it. So we should be kind of wrapping up the living quarters here. I'll start working on the dorms, I think, next. I know a lot of people were saying how, like, you can't put in a stove and a kitchen and all that jazz, but when I was doing free build like I am here, I was able to do all of those things. None of that was ever an issue, but I think it's just more of like the realism aspect that obviously a lot of dorms don't actually possess a full kitchen, that you'd have to like go down to like the cafeteria or something if you wanted a taste of that good life. But I didn't put that in. I did just kind of like add in some other fun little activities and stuff. Like, there's plenty to do here. Like, honestly, you probably never even have to leave. But anyway, putting up some curtains. I really like those. I don't know if I keep them or I delete them, but I actually really love how they kind of bring something else to the room. I was struggling so bad, you guys. I was trying to figure out like what painting I was going to put on this wall or what I was going to do. But eventually I come to a conclusion. We decided to ditch the painting idea and put up some beautiful, beautiful, beautiful little wall sconces and instead, and I actually scattered them throughout the house, and I feel like this little added detail kind of just ties in everything. Might I add, it has been months, 300 days, that's an exaggeration, 30 days times like 90 days, okay, like it's been a really long time since you girl has built anything, and when I'm telling you, I was nervous, I was sweating, that I was going to be a big freaking flop-a-saurus. I was definitely feeling that type of vibe, but I, like I said, I really am proud of how it all kind of came together. It's exactly what I would have imagined, and I really do feel like brown is just, brown's how I get down. Like, if I can use brown, there's nothing I can or can't create. So I definitely want to do more of these like renovations. I'm thinking probably doing like a Foxberry one or something along those lines, something a little more modern. I'm adding in a bunch, like I said earlier, a bunch of activities. I have like a chess table, we got beer pong, we got juice pong. There really isn't much that you're going to need to really buy for your Sims, depending on what dorm room you pick. So, like, again, I have a few dorms. I made them very unisex, so, like, you could live in any of them. Some are a little more feminine, okay, like, loose quotations, than others. But, again, I kept it really kind of just gender neutral so that you could decide where you wanted to live. I think I even have one room with three beds in it. I mean, if you really wanted to have that super tight anchovy type of feel, I got you. But we're working on the first dorm right now. And again, I don't want to tell you what your dorm room Finley is going to be choosing, because I honestly don't know yet. I have no idea. So if there's like any that like stands out to you, you're like, oh, that would be perfect for her, let me know. But for the dorms, oh my God, I can't even tell you how fun it is building an entire floor of dorms. Like, at first it's like, I'm only gonna do one, but then it's gonna stand out, so like it's gonna be like an eyesore compared to the rest of the floor plan. And so I decided just to do it all at once, and again, I'm so happy with that decision. Even if you suck at building, you absolutely need to try at least one floor, and it doesn't actually take that long. It took me an hour, which I definitely expected or anticipated for it to be way longer than that, but everything just kind of came to me, and I'm super happy. I'm so excited. I will also be posting this on the gallery. It's going to kind of show up as like a penthouse build because it has the same type of system as the apartments and penthouses in, I want to say, City Living. So I don't know how it all works, to be honest, but I will definitely have this on the gallery when I am allowed to, which I do believe is like tomorrow or something, I want to say. So if you guys wanted to get your manitos on it and play with it, you are absolutely free to do so, and I hope you enjoy and you have an amazing freaking time. So if you're wondering about how much it costs to stay here, believe it or not, it's only $100 more than the dorm surrounding. So as you guys know, there's like four dorm lots total. They all kind of range around like the 300 price range, like for a semester, and I think this one is like 461 or something like that. It wasn't a very significant price increase at all, but obviously the more luxurious the dorm, the more luxurious the price tag you will be banking, you know what I mean? So this room here is kind of cool. I was almost thinking maybe this would be the one that Finn would stay in, just because it kind of just gives me like these princess vibes, and I also really wanted to give the illusion like she was out of Willow Creek, you know. I wanted her to feel like she was like in a different freaking country or something, and I really feel like this particular dorm lot gives gives you that exact essence. And so I wanted to also have like a college cram room and literally put every bed that I could freaking fit in it. And I really, really love like the three little musketeers. They're just there. I don't know who would be in this room. It ain't gonna be Finn, I'll tell you that much. But maybe if you wanted to kind of, you know, live a little bit on the wild side, this is definitely for you, because I'm telling you, the second I freaking made this lot playable, I had random things just popping up everywhere. Like, these dorm mates are really just wild. And I mean, they're crazy. Like, I don't even understand where the hell they get all this stuff. We've got robots here. We've got crystals over there. I don't know what's going on. I want no part of it. But yeah, if you really love that type of like busy life and you want to feel like you are living with people, honey, you can't get any closer than this. I'm being honest with you. So we've got like two more dorm rooms to complete. I'll tell you, my favorite one, I think, is the last one. It's like super gung-ho Brightchester. And that's kind of like another thing that I wanted to emulate in this room. I wanted it to be very, 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 very Brightchester. So you're going to notice like a lot of elements of green just here and there and like literally everywhere. But I also wanted it to kind of have that old English vibe. So I wanted to use all different types of like materials. You know, I have like the fabric couch mixed with the leather. We've got wood. We've got light wood, dark wood, all different types of things. So even though, yes, again, Jen's back to her neutral. Nasty neutrals. It's different. It all has its own, you know, like element here and there and everywhere. So I loved the fact that microwave was pink. Doesn't really match, but kind of does. You know what I mean? And I feel like you just can't go wrong. So we're kind of coming towards the end of the build. If you guys are wondering when that very first episode of The Sims 4 Discover University featuring the Foremans is going to air, I have great news for you. It's going to be coming sometime today, rather sooner than later. I have been like really working super, super, super hard. I don't know if I mentioned this already, on the save itself, and that has just taken up so much of my damn time. And I wanted to do it when I had Discover University, so I didn't have to like go back and like, you know, fix things. So it's gonna be an interesting start, but it's going to be an amazing season as per usual. We're really going back to the roots of family. We're really going back to just kind of focusing on one sim and creating their story and having like the rest of the family kind of be in the foreground. Get it? Okay, that was just really cheesy. Speaking of cheesy, I guess there's some new types of pizzas. So I'm wondering if you're able to like actually order services. I think that you are. If I'm not mistaken, you can order services while you're at like on your dorm. You can like get a butler. You can actually just give the butler like one of your dorm mates' rooms or beds, because you can assign beds, and then you could just like have him cleaning up. I'm telling you, you might be laughing at me and thinking, wow, that is really pretentious. But yo, when you live here and you've got like dirty chicken carcasses and like slices of God only knows what and socks literally everywhere, that butler thing really won't be a bad idea after all. And trust me, it'll save you so much stress and anxiety. Is not even a freaking joke. But yeah, so anyway, I think, did I already do the Brightchester room? I feel like I did. I'm just kind of like adding in some more final touches. I really wanted, yeah, I did. I love it though. You guys can kind of see it has like the Brightchester comforter. I wanted there to be enough space to move around in the dorm. So if they are a little vague, that's the reason why. Presentation boards kind of take up a very large amount of space and they can be quite chunky. So there's that. That's kind of why there's like a dead space in the middle for most of the builds. But anyways, guys, I'm gonna go ahead and wrap up the speed build here. If you guys enjoyed it, please don't forget to go ahead and let me know in the comments down below, as well as give me a big old freaking fat thumbs up. And with that said, y'all, I'm gonna go ahead wrap up this video here. Again, I hope you all enjoyed, and if you did, you know what to do, boo. Don't forget to go ahead and comment, rate, and subscribe. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below where the sun doesn't shine, and I will see you all next time. Bye, guys. Que él se ve, se dé cuenta que aquí perdió esa mujer. Lo que quiere es enloquecer, ser la mujer que él quería ver. Esa chica quiere selfie, selfie, que yo parezca él. Como que ella quiere disfrutar la noche, lo anormal. Lo que el novio teme, que su relación va a terminar. Se da cuenta que no necesita alguien más. Quiere un selfie para su Instagram. Right. Ella ya no quiere relación. Alguien que diga su condición. Que solamente le dé traición. Pa' después llegar con un perdón. Quiere hangar y ser de esos pibis que goza la vida y lo hacen con.
yo esa mujer, perdió esa mujer. Lo que quiere es enloquecerse, la mujer que él quería ver. Esa chica quiere selfie, selfie, que yo parezca en mí, que yo parezca en mí.
No tiene sueños, solamente en sus sueños. Nos ponemos risueños con un norteño y mi flow brasileño.